No finger marks on the knife blades, please.
At Morrison's Hotel.
Mr. Nobbs?
She prefers roses. Lilies make her sneeze.
The service is impeccable.
What sweet roses, Nobbs.
Man.
Such a kind little man.
The staff.
Now, drinks.
Albert?
Is outstanding.
I've been thinking that we need a strong man about the house.
God, but isn't he a smasher?
He'll only take advantage of a girl and then leave her high and dry.
High maybe, but I wouldn't say dry.
And appearances.
Mr. Hubert Page is working in the morning and he's come over and asked us for a bed.
With me, ma'am?
Yes, Mr. Nobbs. With you.
Are deceiving.
Jesus. You're a woman.
You won't tell on me.
What's your name?
Albert.
Your real name?
Albert.
You don't have to be anything but who you are. Look at how you've survived all these years. You've worked hard and you've saved your money.
You've it all stashed under the mattress, is it, Mr. Nobbs?
I've been thinking I might purchase a little shop. A woman could serve at the counter.
You're not thinking of taking a wife.
Who's the lucky lady?
I was wondering if you would come out for a walk.
Are you asking me to walk out with you?
Sure, why not? It's a waste of money, I think.
Would you like to go in?
All right.
Why aren't you in fancy dress?
I'm a waiter.
And I'm a doctor. We are both disguised as ourselves.
He's a freak.
He has manners, at least.
Well, his manners won't get you to America now, will they?
We'll make a great success of our shop, and our wedding will be a great wonder.
What kind of man would ask a girl to marry him without ever having kissed her?
There's something I have to tell you.
He won't take you to America. He'll leave you here.
I'll take care of you.
Why don't you say to me what you're saying to her?
Maybe we'll find there the key to your dreams. So you just lay your head down, darling.
I think you are the strangest man I've ever met.
Sleep now.